Dear friends, in the first video on regional groupings, we discussed 20 important topics. In this second video on regional groupings, we will discuss another 20 topics. So totally, we have targeted 40 important topics in this regional groupings. 21st topic is G20. India is a member of G20. Why G20 came in the news? G20 came in the news because of the Osaka Summit 2019. In June 2019, the 14th G20 summit took place in Osaka in Japan. What is important in this Osaka summit? 2019, Osaka Track on Digital Economy was a very important initiative which was launched by the Japan Prime Minister Shinzo Abe, which seeks the removal of prohibitions on data localization. This initiative was supported by US and Europe, whereas India, Indonesia oppose this initiative. Now, what do you mean by data localization? Data localization means that companies collecting critical data about the consumers must store and process the data within the Indian borders. This is called as data localization. In April 2018, RBI asked payment firms to ensure their data are stored exclusively on local servers. It also was setting a tight 6-month deadline for compliance. However, the deadline was not followed by some foreign firms, including credit card giants like Visa and MasterCard. India, South Africa, Indonesia boycotted the Osaka Track on Digital Economy because it undermines multilateralism. It is only promoting. What is plurilateralism? Plurilateralism means informal negotiation between two or more countries. Whereas multilateralism emphasizes on consensus-based decision, which is approved by WTO, plurilateralism do not emphasize on consensus. So, Osaka Track is giving importance to plurilateral negotiations, which is against the multilateral concept which was approved by WTO. This is one important reason why India, South Africa and Indonesia boycotted this Osaka Track on Digital Economy. Some background information about G20. It is an international forum for the governments and the central bank governors coming from 19 countries and European Union. So, G20 consists of 19 countries and one regional grouping called as European Union. This was established during the 1997-98 financial crisis. In December 1999, the first G20 summit was taking place in Berlin, which was hosted by Germany as well as Canada. The main objective of this summit is to discuss the policies related to financial stability. However, in 2008, the agenda of G20 got expanded to include the heads of the governments as well as heads of the states. The finance ministers and the foreign ministers started attending the summit since 2008. So, November 2008, the first summit took place in Washington, which was attended by the heads of the governments or heads of the states as well as the finance ministers and the foreign ministers of G20 countries. In June 2019, the 14th summit took place in Osaka, Japan. We have seen this. November 2020, 15th summit is going to take place in Riyadh in Saudi Arabia. 2021 summit is the 16th summit, which is going to take place in Italy. And 2022 is very, very important because the 17th G20 summit will be for the first time hosted by India in New Delhi. So for the first time, India will host the annual G20 summit in 2022. This is why the G20 is very, very important. So for the first time, India will be hosting the G20 annual summit in 2022 in New Delhi. Next topic is the 22nd topic on group of 7 nations called as G7. G7 was in news because in August 2019, the 45th G7 summit took place in Biarritz in France. Biarritz is a place in France. In this place only the 45th G7 summit took place. India was invited as a special guest in the G7 summit, which took place in France in August 2019, which is why this is very important. Some background information about G7. In 1975, it was formed as an intergovernmental organization during the global oil crisis, which took place in 1975. The members of G7 are US, Canada, UK, France, Germany, Italy, and Japan. All the seven countries in 1975 formed this grouping called as G7. Later, Russia got added as the 8th member. In 1997, G7 was known as G8 after the inclusion of Russia. However, in 2014, Russia was expelled because of annexation of the Crimean region of Ukraine. So, Russia annexed the Crimean region of Ukraine in 2014. So, Russia was expelled from G8. Now, G8 becomes G7. The G7 nations meet at an annual summit presided by the head of the member countries on rotational basis. Now, some information about the Crimean annexation by Russia. This is Crimea. This place is Crimea and this belongs to Ukraine. In 2014, Russia annexed this Crimea militarily. Some background information about Crimea. In 1783, Crimea became a part of the Russian Empire, but in 1954, it was transferred to Ukraine. But in 2014, Russia annexed Crimea from Ukraine. Because of this Crimean annexation, Russia was expelled from G8. G7 do not have any formal constitution. It is not having any fixed headquarters. The decisions arrived during the G7 summits are not binding decisions, and India is not a member of G7 group. Next, 23rd topic is on Mekong Ganga cooperation. It came in the news because in August 2019, the 10th Mekong Ganga cooperation ministerial meeting took place in Bangkok in Thailand, which is why it came in the news. 2020 is the 20th anniversary of Mekong Ganga cooperation. Some background information about Mekong Ganga. In the year 2000, India and five Asian countries including Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam, Myanmar and Thailand launched this Mekong Ganga cooperation at the Laos headquarters called as Vientiane. So India plus five Asian countries including Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam, Myanmar, Thailand, they launched this Mekong Ganga cooperation at Vientiane in Laos. They emphasize on cooperation in four areas including tourism. In 2019, India-ASEAN tourism year was declared. Culture, third is education, fourth is transport and communication. Once India hosted this MGC meeting, the 6th Mekong Ganga cooperation meeting was hosted by New Delhi in September 12. September 2012, 6th MGC meeting was hosted by New Delhi. So far, only one MGC meeting was hosted by New Delhi. That was in September 2012. These are the six members of Mekong Ganga cooperation: India, Myanmar, Laos, Thailand, Cambodia, and Vietnam. These are the six member countries of Mekong Ganga cooperation. In this map, we are seeing the Mekong River. It flows through these countries. So it flows through China, right? It flows through China, then Myanmar, then Laos, then Thailand, then Cambodia and Vietnam. So these are the countries through which Mekong River flows. Mekong is the world's 12th longest river and the 7th longest river in Asia. It starts from Tibetan Plateau. It runs through China, Myanmar, Laos, Thailand, Cambodia and Vietnam. This map shows the Ganga River basin. So this is the Ganga River. Look at the left bank tributaries of Ganga. Ghagra, Gandak, they are left bank tributaries of Ganga. Which are the right bank tributaries? Yamuna, then Tones, then Son. These are the right bank tributaries of Ganga River. Next is 24th topic on Mekong River Commission, MRC, for sustainable development. It came in the news because in April 2020, 25th anniversary of Mekong River Commission will be commemorated. It was formed on April 5, 1995 as an intergovernmental river basin organization established by the riparian countries. Which countries formed this MRC? Cambodia, Laos, Thailand, Vietnam. These are the four countries which floated the Mekong River Commission. China and Myanmar are the dialogue partners. The headquarters or the secretariat of MRC is Vientiane in Laos. Next is 25th topic on Lakang Mekong Cooperation. Lakang Mekong Cooperation. Mekong is known as Lankan after flowing out of the Yunnan province of China. So the other name for Mekong in China is Lankang. LMC, that is Lankang Mekong Cooperation, is seen as a rival to MRC, that is Mekong River Commission. This MRC is supported by ADB. LMC is initiated by China. China do not want MRC floated or MRC supported by ADB, which is why LMC was floated as a rival to MRC by China. On 23rd of March 2016, the first LMC leaders meeting took place in Sanya, which is in China's Hainan province. Mekong River, already we have seen, Mekong River runs across Myanmar, Thailand, Laos, Cambodia, Vietnam. It is called as Lankang in China. The China-led initiative for cooperation on LMC. LMC is China-led initiative for cooperation on the Lankang Mekong River. All riparian countries, including Cambodia, China, Laos, Myanmar, Thailand, Vietnam, are the members of LMC. The secretariat of LMC is in Beijing, China. This map shows the Mekong River. So it flows through China, Myanmar. It flows through China, Myanmar, Thailand, Cambodia, Laos and Vietnam. These are the countries in LMC, Lakang Mekong Cooperation. These are the members present in LMC, that is Lakang Mekong Cooperation. Next is 26th topic. It's on India-ASEAN review of Free Trade Pact. So India and ASEAN decided to review the FTA, which is why this came in the news. Recently, India and ASEAN, that is Association of Southeast Asian Nations, agreed to review the FTA, which was signed in 2009. Also in 2019 November, the Prime Minister of India attended the 16th ASEAN-India Summit, which took place in Bangkok, Thailand. These are the two reasons why this ASEAN came in the news. Some background information about ASEAN and India relation. 1992, India became ASEAN's sectoral dialogue partner. In 1995, it became full dialogue partner. In 1996, India became a member of ASEAN Regional Forum, that is ARF. In 2003, Comprehensive Economic Cooperation Agreement, that is CECA, was signed between India and ASEAN. In 2009, India-ASEAN FTA was signed in Bangkok. On 1st July 2015, India-ASEAN agreements on trade in services and investments were signed between India and ASEAN. 2017 marks the 25 years of dialogue partnership between India and ASEAN as well as 5 years of strategic partnership. So in 2012, India-ASEAN declared that they are strategic partners. So this is marking, 2017 is marking the 5 years of strategic partnership between India and ASEAN and 25 years of dialogue partnership between India and ASEAN, because India became a dialogue partner of ASEAN in 1992. What is the impact of free trade agreement on India? Bilateral trade between India and ASEAN increased. In 2017, bilateral trade was $73.6 billion, but in the next year, 2018, it increased to $80.8 billion. ASEAN is the India's fourth largest trading partner. However, India's trade deficit in goods has widened from $13 billion in the financial year 2018 to $22 billion in the financial year 2019. So even though trade increased, trade deficit also increased. Some background information about ASEAN. In August 1967, five countries, Indonesia, Malaysia, Singapore, Philippines, and Thailand, they floated this ASEAN. So there are five founders of ASEAN. Later, five other countries joined the grouping. They are Brunei, Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar, and Vietnam. So ASEAN consists of 10 member countries. 27th topic is ASEAN outlook on the Indo-Pacific. This is the Indo-Pacific region. ASEAN came out with its vision on Indo-Pacific region, which is why it came in the news. In June 2019, ASEAN adopted the ASEAN outlook on Indo-Pacific, which is why it came in the news. This ASEAN's outlook on Indo-Pacific enumerates four functional areas of collaboration. They are maritime cooperation, connectivity, sustainable development, and economic cooperation. These are the four functional areas of collaboration according to ASEAN's outlook on Indo-Pacific declared in June 2019. The 28th topic is Indian Ocean Naval Symposium. What came in the news? It came in the news because in Feb 2020, the Chief of Indian Navy, Admiral Karamveer Singh, visited Myanmar, and Myanmar is a member of Indian Ocean Naval Symposium. By 2020, the 7th symposium will be hosted by France. In the year 2008, inaugural Indian Ocean Naval Symposium seminar was held by Indian Navy. So India only hosted the first IONS seminar in 2008. Subsequent seminars and meetings of the Conclave of Chiefs were held every 2 years. So it is a biennial meeting. Every 2 years, the meeting of IONS will take place. April 2018, the 6th symposium took place in Iran. November 2018, 10th anniversary celebration was held in Kochi in Kerala. The theme of this 10th anniversary meeting was IONS as a catalyst for Sagar. Sagar stands for security and growth for all in the region. IONS consists of 24 members who are grouped into four sub-regions. South Asian littoral. This region consists of these countries including Bangladesh, India, Maldives, Pakistan, Seychelles, Sri Lanka and United Kingdom. The second region is West Asian littoral, which consists of Iran, Oman, Saudi and United Arab Emirates. The third region is East African littoral, which includes Reunion Island of France, Kenya, Mauritius, Mozambique, South Africa and Tanzania. The fourth region is Southeast Asian and Australian littorals, including Australia, Indonesia, Myanmar, Singapore, Thailand and Timor. There are 9 observers including China and Japan. IONS is very important for India because this IONS does not have China as a member. China is only an observer along the 9 observers. So it is an initiative which was led by India basically, IONS. 29th topic is Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, RCEP. These are the RCEP countries. Now it came in the news because India is walking out of RCEP. RCEP came in the news because in July 2019, the 26th round of negotiation for RCEP was held in Melbourne in Australia. In February 2020, 15 countries out of 16 ASEAN plus 6 countries, 15 countries excluding India decided to enter into the trade agreement. So excluding India, 16 countries of RCEP decided in Feb 2020 that they will enter into the trade agreement called RCEP. Recently, India decided not to join RCEP because India is having some reservations with Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. Some basic information about RCEP. RCEP consists of 10 ASEAN countries plus 6 others. It is called as ASEAN plus 3 plus 3. The 6 other countries are New Zealand, Australia, China, Japan, India and South Korea. So ASEAN plus 6, RCEP consists of therefore ASEAN plus 6, 16 countries. But India is going to walk out of RCEP. Talks on 7 of the 16 chapters of the agreement got completed, but there are some areas which are still being negotiated. Key areas including goods, services, investment are still being negotiated. So the negotiation on some key areas of goods, services and investment has not been completed. RCEP is likely to be signed by middle of 2020. Why India declared that it is walking out of RCEP? India is having some concerns. For example, India's trade deficit is widening with the countries after signing of free trade agreements. India signed FTA with ASEAN, Japan, Korea as well as Singapore. After signing of FTA, even though the trade increased, but the trade deficit also increased. India's merchandise trade deficit with RCEP is more than $100 billion in the financial year 2019. This is equal to 60% of India's total trade deficit. So out of total trade deficit of India, 60% of trade deficit is with that of RCEP countries. Also, this RCEP is a threat to domestic market. There is a possibility of more dumping of the Chinese goods, and there is a heavy competition which India will face in the fields like agriculture, horticulture and dairy with that of Australia and New Zealand. These two countries are giants in the field of dairy, agriculture and horticulture. So these two countries will pose severe challenge to India. The concern which India has raised is about WTO plus. WTO plus is nothing but agreements which are not emphasized by WTO is emphasized by RCEP countries. Even WTO is not warranting the signature of some agreements, but RCEP countries, especially Japan, South Korea, they are emphasizing on India-like countries to sign some agreements which is not even present in WTO agreement. For example, RCEP country wanted India to sign this International Union for Protection of New Varieties of Plants, UPOV. India rejected this because this UPOV is not necessitated by even WTO. So how can you compel us to sign some agreements which is not even emphasized by WTO? So you are pushing us to sign some dozen of agreement which is not stipulated by WTO. These agreements are called as WTO plus. So this is the main concern of India, that we are ready to sign only agreements as stipulated by WTO. We cannot sign any new agreement which is not stipulated by WTO to become a member of RCEP. And this is the main reason why India is declaring of walking out of RCEP. The 30th topic is African Continental Free Trade Area, creating one African market. In March 2018, African Union met in Rwanda's capital called as Kigali. In this Kigali meeting, African Union declared that they'll come out with African Continental Free Trade Area, which is why this is very, very important. This is the political map of African Union countries. All the countries in Africa, they are the members of African Union. In this discussion, we will be speaking about the conflict between Ethiopia, Eritrea, then we'll speak about Niger, we'll speak about Nigeria also. July 2019, the 12th summit of African Union took place in Niger in Niamey. 54 out of 55 members of African Union, they signed this African Continental Free Trade Agreement for the goods as well as services. This is in fact the biggest free trade area as created by this African Union. So far 27 countries have ratified this agreement. One country out of 55, only 54 signed, one country did not sign. That country is Eritrea. Eritrea is the only country not signing the agreement. Some background information about Eritrea and its problem in joining this free trade agreement. Eritrea was administered by British military administration until 1952. In 1952, UN General Assembly made a decision that Eritrea would govern itself with a local Eritrean parliament. But for foreign affairs and defense, it will enter into a federal status with that of Ethiopia for 10 years. So, Eritrea will have its own parliament, but for defense and foreign relation, it will enter into an agreement with Ethiopia for 10 years. This decision was made by UN General Assembly in 1952. In 1962, Ethiopian government annexed Eritrea. So, from 1961 to 1991, Eritrea was launching a war of independence against Ethiopia. But in May 1998, Eritrea invaded Badmi region of Ethiopia, and this triggered Ethiopia to annex the disputed territory from Eritrea. So, Ethiopia occupied the disputed territory against Eritrea. From May 1998 to June 2000, Eritrea-Ethiopian war was taking place. However, in December 2000, that is December 12, 2000, there was a peace agreement called as Algiers Agreement, which was signed in Algeria. Algiers Agreement was signed in Algeria, which is a peace agreement. Algiers is the place in Algeria. In this place only, a peace agreement was signed between Eritrea and Ethiopia to bring the war to an end on December 2, 2000, called as Algiers Agreement. Subsequently, another peace agreement was signed in 2018. Because of this peace agreement, Eritrea can now participate in the free trade agreement. So, there is no barrier for Eritrea's joining of the free trade agreement because of the peace agreement signed in 2018. In this map, we'll see Ethiopia-Eritrea border dispute. Eritrea occupied this Badmi region of Ethiopia, resulting in Ethiopia invading Eritrea. Eritrea is bordered by Sudan, it is bordered by Ethiopia as well as Djibouti. Djibouti is very famous because here only the first offshore naval base of China was established. Why China wanted Djibouti naval base? To contain piracy in this Gulf of Aden. Gulf of Aden is a very piracy infected place, and they wanted to protect the Gulf of Aden, which is why China started its first naval base in Djibouti. Now come to Eritrea-Ethiopia dispute. Ethiopia is having its capital in Addis Ababa. Ethiopia is bordered by Eritrea. Then here you have South Sudan. Here you have Kenya. And here you have Somalia. Right? So these are the bordering countries of Ethiopia, Eritrea. Then we have Sudan. Then South Sudan, Kenya, Somalia. These are the bordering countries of Ethiopia. On 7th July 2019, Nigeria, which is Africa's most populous country, was one of the last nation to sign the agreement. So Nigeria was the country which signed the agreement last on July 7th, 2019. Somaliland was not a part of the agreement because it is unrecognized state. The unrecognized state of Somaliland was not a party to the discussion related to the creation of African Common Market. Some basic information about Africa Continental Free Trade Area. This would be the world's largest FTA to create an African Common Market. So the largest FTA to create an African Common Market will be African Continental Free Trade Area. It connects 1.2 billion people in the world. March 21, 2018, the agreement was brokered by African Union in a place called as Kigali, which is the capital of Rwanda. This agreement was signed by 44 out of 55 member states in Kigali in Rwanda, March 21, 2018. The members decided that they will remove tariff on 90% of the goods. They will also allow free access to services across Africa. The free trade zone should be operational from July 2020. This common market will definitely boost the intra-African trade. So far, the intra-African trade is only 16% of the total trade of the goods and services of Africa. Out of total trade of Africa, intra-Africa trade is only 16%. With the signing of this African Continental Free Trade Agreement, intra-African trade will increase to 60% by the year 2022. The agreement has to come into force 30 days after ratification by 22 signatory states. On April 2, 2019, Gambia became the 22nd state to ratify. So on May 30, 2019, African Continental Free Trade Agreement came into force. A small note on the Colombo Plan. 29th. A small note on Colombo Plan. What is Colombo Plan? On 28 November 1950, this Colombo Plan for cooperative economic and social development in Asia Pacific was agreed. In 1954, official development assistance was started after Japan signed this Colombo Plan. Colombo Plan pledges to provide aid to those nations who need it. Japan is the biggest ODA provider, and Japan is keen to launch Asia-Africa Growth Corridor to connect Asia and Africa. Next topic is on Asia-Africa Growth Corridor. This map shows how the current route is a lengthier route. Follow the blue color line. The current route to Africa, the current connection between Africa and Asia is a very, very lengthy route. But this Asia-Africa Growth Corridor will provide a very short connectivity between Asia and Africa. So, India will be connected to Africa. Japan will be connected to Africa through this Asia-Africa Growth Corridor. November 2016, joint declaration was signed by the Prime Minister of India and the Prime Minister of Japan for this Asia-Africa Growth Corridor. May 2017, India and Japan released a vision document on the Asia-Africa Growth Corridor at the 52nd annual meeting of the African Development Bank in Gandhinagar. Asia-Africa Growth Corridor is a response to BRI. So this is rival to BRI. It is portrayed as a response to BRI. China's trade with Africa is $200 billion in the year 2018. But Japan's trade with Africa is only $17 billion. So, Japan wanted to have more access to African trade. So, Japan wanted to boost its trade with Africa. Therefore, it is conceiving this project called as Asia-Africa Growth Corridor. Between 2000 to 2017, in this 17-year period, China has given loan to Africa, which is equivalent to $143 billion. So, such a huge loan China has given to African governments in this 17-year period. The four pillars of Asia-Africa Growth Corridor will be development and cooperation projects, quality infrastructure and institutional connectivity, enhancing capacities and skills, people-to-people partnership. These are the four pillars of Asia-Africa Growth Corridor. The 32nd topic will be African Union. African Union came in the news because in February 2020, the 33rd summit took place in Addis Ababa in Ethiopia. Addis Ababa is the headquarters of Ethiopia. Some basic information about African Union. In May 1963, Organization for African Unity was created by 32 heads of independent African states in Addis Ababa. By September 1999, there was a declaration made in Libya called as Sirte Declaration, calling for the establishment of African Union. So in July 2002, African Union was formally launched in Durban in South Africa. There are 55 members of African Union. It includes all the countries in African continent. The headquarters of African Union is Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. On 31st January 2015, 24th Ordinary Assembly of African Union in Addis Ababa came out with Agenda 2063. What is Agenda 2063? Agenda 2063 is Africa's blueprint for transforming Africa into a global powerhouse. 33rd topic will be Arab League. These are the countries which are shaded in the green color. They are the members of Arab League. So Arab League consists of members from this Persian Gulf as well as Africa. Arab League came in the news because in September 2019, Arab League condemned the Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's plan to annex the eastern portion of the West Bank known as Jordan Valley. So Arab League condemned the Israeli Prime Minister's annexation plan. Israeli PM plans to annex the Jordan Valley, which is the eastern portion of West Bank occupied by Israel. In this map, we'll see where is Jordan Valley. Jordan Valley is marked in the yellow color. This is what is Jordan Valley, the east of the West Bank. West Bank was occupied from Jordan by Israel in 1967, Six-Day War. Similarly, Golan Heights was occupied from Syria by Israel. Gaza Strip was occupied by Israel from Egypt. Golan Heights came in the previous year question. They asked Golan Heights is present in which of the following places? West Asia is the place. So it belongs to Syria, but it was annexed by Israel during the 1967 Six-Day War, which took place between June 5 to June 10. Similarly, Gaza Strip was annexed from Egypt and Western Bank was annexed from Jordan. Now, where is Israel? This is Israel. Israel is surrounded by Lebanon. It is surrounded by Lebanon, Syria, Jordan, and Egypt. Israel is surrounded by Lebanon, Syria, Jordan, and Egypt. Now, these two came in the news. One is Dead Sea, and another is Sea of Galilee. Dead Sea is called dead because its high salinity prevents macroscopic aquatic organisms like fish and aquatic plants from living in it. So that is why it is called as Dead Sea. It is the lowest water body in the earth. It is a salt water lake. Sea of Galilee came in the news because this is getting dried up. So in 2018, Israel government decided that it will pump 100 million cubic meter of fresh water into the Sea of Galilee by 2022. However, because of the rain in January, February 2020, Sea of Galilee water level increased. So people are very happy because of the rising water level of Sea of Galilee, which is the most important fresh water source for the people of Israel. April 2019, the 36th summit of Arab League took place in Tunisia in Tunis. October 2019, Arab League met in Cairo to condemn the Turkish move to invade Syria. So Turkey was planning to invade Syria, which was condemned by Arab League in the Cairo meet, which took place in October 2019. This is Syria. The map shows Syria. Syria is bordered by Turkey, Iraq, Jordan, and Lebanon, as well as Israel. Syria is bordered by Turkey, Lebanon, Israel, Jordan, and Iraq. Damascus is the capital of Syria. So Turkey wanted to invade Syria, and which is condemned by Arab League in the Cairo meeting. Some background information about Arab League. In October 1944, there was a protocol signed by five Arab countries called as Alexandria Protocol. Alexandria is a place in Egypt. The five Arab countries who signed Alexandria Protocol are Egypt, Iraq, Syria, Jordan and Lebanon. These five countries, they agreed to form a joint Arab organization. In 1944, Alexandria Protocol decided by these five countries to create an Arab organization. March 22, 1945, Arab League was formed in Cairo, which is in Egypt, by six members. They are Egypt, Iraq, Jordan, Lebanon, Saudi and Syria. These six are the founder countries of Arab League. May 1945, Yemen joined. Today there are 22 members. But on Feb 22, 2011, Libya was suspended because of the civil war. And 16th November 2011, Syria was suspended because of the civil war. So, two countries got suspended from Arab League. Number one is Libya, number two, Syria, because of the civil war. In this map, we can see the 22 member countries of Arab League. Kindly make a note of the 22 member countries of Arab League. Relation between Arab League and Palestine. In 1964, in the Cairo summit, Arab League initiated the creation of a Palestinian organization. So, June 2, 1964, Palestinian Liberation Organization was founded and Palestine is a full-fledged member of Arab League. March 28, 2002, there was a summit called as Beirut Summit, which adopted the Arab Peace Initiative. This Arab Peace Initiative is a Saudi-inspired peace plan for ending the Arab-Israel conflict. This is the map of Israel. This is West Bank, which was occupied from Jordan. This is Gaza Strip, occupied from Egypt during the six-day war, which took place between 5th of June to 10th of June in 1967. This is the bone of contention, Jerusalem. Jerusalem is a very, very important place for religious communities like the Jew people and the Muslims. So therefore, this is a very, very important place of contention. According to the Oslo Accord, East Jerusalem should be the capital of Palestine. But however, Jerusalem is claimed by Israel totally. Next topic is on Gulf Cooperation Council. 33rd topic is Gulf Cooperation Council. These are the member countries of GCC, Gulf Cooperation Council: Kuwait, Bahrain, Qatar, UAE, Oman and Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. These are the members of Gulf Cooperation Council. Kuwait, Bahrain, Qatar, UAE, Oman and Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. GCC came in the news because in December 2019, the 40th summit took place in Riyadh. Some basic information about Gulf Cooperation Council. It is an intergovernmental political and economic union. It consists of all the Arab states of Persian Gulf except Iraq. So, Iraq is not a member of Gulf Cooperation Council. Iraq is not a member of GCC. Other members are Bahrain, Kuwait, Oman, Qatar, Saudi and United Arab Emirates. May 25, 1981, GCC was formally established. All the current member states are monarchies. There are three constitutional monarchies like Qatar, Kuwait and Bahrain. There are two absolute monarchies like Saudi Arabia and Oman. And there is one federal monarchy called as United Arab Emirates. Discussions are going on regarding the future membership of three countries, Jordan, Morocco and Yemen. In 2011, Saudi Arabia proposed to transform GCC into a Gulf Union with tighter economic, political and military coordination to counterbalance Iraq. So, there is a division between Iraq versus Saudi Arabia-led countries. In this map, we see Yemen, then Morocco, and Jordan. These three countries wanted to join in this Gulf Cooperation Council, Yemen, Jordan and Morocco. Yemen is bordered by Saudi Arabia and Oman. Algeria is bordered by Morocco and Western Sahara. Jordan is bordered by Syria, Iraq, Saudi Arabia, Egypt and Israel. These are the bordering countries of Jordan. Iraq is the only Arab country bordering the Persian Gulf which is not a member of GCC. So Iraq is the only Arab country which is bordering the Persian Gulf, but it is not a member of GCC. Jordan and Morocco are the two Arab monarchies which are not currently in the council. They are therefore wanting to become the new members of GCC. Jordan has border with Saudi Arabia. Jordan is also economically connected to Persian Gulf states. But Morocco is not near the Persian Gulf. Morocco, Jordan, they are the monarchies, Arab monarchies, who are not currently in the council, but they are going to become new members of Gulf Cooperation Council. In this map, we'll see where is Saudi. Saudi is here. Riyadh is the capital of Saudi Arabia. Saudi is bordered by Yemen, Oman, UAE, Qatar, Kuwait, Iraq and Jordan. These are the bordering countries of Saudi Arabia. Gulf Organization for Industrial Consulting was founded in 1976 by the six GCC members. In 2009, Yemen joined this grouping. This grouping is having its headquarters in Doha, which is the capital of Qatar. Now we'll speak about the rift between Qatar and Saudi. Saudi-Qatar diplomatic conflict was because of the allegation made by Saudi Arabia against Qatar that Qatar is supporting rebels and the terrorists like Muslim Brotherhood in Middle East, North Africa, Hamas and the radical groups in Libya. This support of Qatar to these groups caused destabilization of the region, which is why Saudi Arabia is having a diplomatic conflict with Qatar. June 2017, Bahrain, Saudi, UAE, Egypt, they had cut the official ties with that of Qatar. Later in 2017, June, Saudi, UAE, Bahrain put a ban on the Qataris and their businesses. Khaliji was a proposed name of the common currency of GCC. Like Euro is for European Union, they wanted to create Khaliji for Gulf Cooperation Council. The 34th topic is on Quad. These are the four countries called Quad countries. Some background information about Quad. Quad consists of four countries: US, Japan, Australia and India. It was formed in response to the 2004-05 Asian tsunami. In 2007, the dialogue was initiated by the Japan Prime Minister Shinzo Abe. In 2017 ASEAN Summit, they wanted to revive this Quad. The 35th topic is on NAM, Non-Aligned Movement. Some reason why NAM came in the news. October 2019, the Vice President of India attended the 18th NAM Summit, which took place in Baku in Azerbaijan. The theme of the NAM Summit, 18th NAM Summit, was upholding the Bandung Principle to ensure concerted and adequate response to the challenges of the contemporary world. For the second time, the Prime Minister of India did not attend the NAM Summit. Now some basic facts about NAM. In 1955, Asia-Africa Conference was held in Bandung in Indonesia. In 1961, first conference was held in Belgrade, which is the capital of Serbia. India, Yugoslavia, Egypt, Ghana and Indonesia participated in the Belgrade conference. Today there are 120 members. NAM is based on five principles called as Panchasheel principle. Panchasheel includes: number one, mutual respect for each other's territorial integrity and sovereignty. Number two, non-interference in each other's military and internal affairs. Number three, mutual non-aggression. Number 4, equality and mutual benefit. Number 5, peaceful coexistence and economic cooperation. These are the 5 principles called as Panchsheel principle. Based on this Panchsheel principle only, NAM has its key principles. 36th topic is on SARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. These are the members of SARC. Afghanistan, which was the 8th member. The founder members are 7. Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Nepal, Pakistan and Sri Lanka. So 7 founder countries. Afghanistan was the 8th country to join this grouping called as SARC. Some background information. In April 1947, Asian Relations Conference was hosted by New Delhi. Countries from all the four corners of Asia participated in this Asian Relations Conference. Subsequently, in May 1950, Baguio Conference was held in Philippines. In this conference, Australia, Ceylon, India, Pakistan and Thailand participated. Then April 1954, Colombo Powers Conference was held in Sri Lanka. Ceylon, Indonesia, Burma, India, Pakistan participated in this Colombo Powers Conference, which was held in Colombo in Sri Lanka. In 1985, SARC Charter was signed in Dhaka by India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Maldives, Nepal and Bhutan. These countries, they are the founder countries of SARC. The Secretariat of SARC was held in Kathmandu in Nepal. In April 2007, Afghanistan became the 8th member to join in this SARC grouping. Now about summits in India. Which SARC summits and all took place in India? 2nd SARC summit took place in 1986 in Bengaluru. 8th summit took place in 1995 in New Delhi. So far, there are 3 summits which has taken place in India. One is 2nd one in Bengaluru, then 8th one in New Delhi, and 14th one in 2007 in New Delhi. So twice in New Delhi and once in Bengaluru, SARC summit took place. November 2014, the last SARC summit took place in Kathmandu. The 19th summit, which was scheduled in 2016 in Pakistan, got cancelled because of the Pathankot and Uri attacks. India, Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Maldives, Sri Lanka, they boycotted this summit, which is why this summit got postponed. In 2016, SAFTA, that is South Asia Free Trade Agreement, came into force. But the intra-regional trade of SARC is less than 5%, so SARC is moving only at a snail's pace in comparison to ASEAN or European Union. The 37th topic is on BBIN agreement, Bhutan, Bangladesh, India, Nepal agreement. It was in news because in Feb 2020, a meeting of Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Nepal on BBIN motor vehicle agreement was held in New Delhi, which is why BBIN was in the news. Some background information about BBIN motor vehicle agreement. November 2014, in the 18th SARC summit in Kathmandu, SARC could not come out with a motor vehicle agreement because of Pakistan. Therefore, BBIN was conceived. In June 2015, 4 countries, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Nepal, they signed a motor vehicle agreement. India, Nepal, Bangladesh ratified the agreement, whereas Bhutan could not get the parliamentary nod because of the environmental concerns. Under a program called as SASEC program, that is South Asia Sub-Regional Economic Cooperation Program, ADB was providing technical advisory and financial support to BBIN. November 1, 2015, a cargo vehicle made the first successful trial run from Kolkata to Agartala via Bangladesh, which reduced the distance by 1000 km. Next, 38th topic on SASEC, South Asia Sub-Regional Economic Cooperation. In 2001, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India and Nepal, they requested Asian Development Bank assistance to promote economic cooperation in the sub-region, and this laid the foundation for the creation of SASEC. May 2014, 2 countries joined, one is Maldives and Sri Lanka.
In February 2017, Myanmar became the 7th member of SASEC. The secretariat of SASEC is in Manila, which is also the headquarters of Asian Development Bank. 39th topic is Brexit. Britain is walking out of European Union. In Jan 2020, UK officially became In Jan 2020, UK has officially left the European Union after 40 years of membership, which is why Brexit came in the news. Some background information about European Union and Brexit. Article 50 of Lisbon Treaty provides for the exit of the member countries from the European Union. Britain was not the founder member of European Union. Only in 1973, Britain or UK joined the European Union. In 2016, there was a referendum which was held in which people decided that UK should leave European Union. So in 2017, UK formally triggered Article 50 of the Lisbon Treaty and began the 2-year countdown of the Brexit. 31st of Jan 2020, UK became the first state to leave European Union. UK will vacate its position from all the European institutions like European Parliament as well as membership in the European Union. Some background information about European Union. In 1951, Paris Treaty was signed between countries like France, West Germany, Italy and the three Benelux countries called Belgium, Luxembourg and Netherlands. So, the six countries, France, Germany, Italy, Belgium, Luxembourg and Netherlands, they signed a treaty called as Paris Treaty to establish European Coal Steel Community. European Coal and Steel Community was a product of Paris Treaty signed by six countries in 1951. In 1957, Rome Treaty was signed by these countries, Belgium, France, Italy, Luxembourg and Netherlands as well as West Germany. They established European Economic Community. So, Rome Treaty founded European Economic Community in 1957. Paris Treaty founded the European Coal and Steel Community in 1951. They are the founder treaties of European Union, Paris Treaty and Rome Treaty. Then in 1991, Maastricht Treaty was signed and in 1993, this treaty came into force. For the first time, the term European Union was mentioned in Maastricht Treaty. So, this is the formal founding of European Union because the name European Union got mentioned only in this treaty called as Maastricht Treaty, which was signed in 1991, which came into force in 1993. Then in 2007, Lisbon Treaty was signed, which came into force in 2009. This Lisbon Treaty brought constitutional amendment to European Union. So European Union is an economic union as well as a political union consisting of 27 member countries belonging to Europe. The relation between India and European Union. Both are negotiating a free trade agreement since 2007. This FTA is called as Broad Based Trade and Investment Agreement. This was asked in the previous question. A very simple question was asked. BTIA is the free trade agreement between which of the following? Answer is India and European Union. The talks on FTA started in 2007, but it stalled in 2013. Later, after 5 years, it got resumed. European Union is the largest trading partner of India. If you look at the bilateral trade, it is 92 billion euro, which is the trade in the goods in the year 2018. If you look at the total trade of India, 12.9% of India's total trade is with European Union. Only 10.9% of India's total trade is with China and only 10.1% of India's total trade is with US. So, European Union is the largest trading partner of India. 40th topic is Financial Action Task Force, FATF. FATF came in the news because in October 2019, FATF session in Paris decided to keep Pakistan in the grey list. Pakistan will be put in the black list if it does not control the terror funding by February 2020. So they have given a target for Pakistan that if you don't act against terrorism, if you don't stop terror funding, then you will be put on the blacklist. Currently, Pakistan is in the grey list. It will be put on the blacklist if it is not acting on terror funding control. Mauritius was also placed on the grey list of the FATF. Some background information about FATF. In July 1989, FATF was established by G7 summit held in Paris. It was created as an intergovernmental body. The initial motive was to combat money laundering. But in October 2001, it included not only money laundering but also combating terror financing and combating human trafficking. Its secretariat is hosted by OECD in Paris. There are 39 members of FATF, out of which 37 are member countries including India and China. And there are two regional groupings who are members of FATF. One is European Commission, another is Gulf Cooperation Council. So two regional grouping and 37 member countries are present in this grouping called as FATF. FATF has two types of lists. One is blacklist, another is grey list. Blacklist countries are those countries who are uncooperative tax havens for terror funding. They are called as non-cooperative countries or territories. As of 21st February 2020, there are two countries placed on the blacklist. One is North Korea, another is Iran. Grey list countries are those countries who might be placed in the blacklist in future if they don't act. It is like a warning given to the countries that they might be placed in the blacklist if they don't achieve the targets. Currently, there are 18 countries who are identified as grey list countries because they are having strategic deficiencies. These countries include Mauritius, Pakistan, etc. Pakistan was placed on the grey list two times, earlier in 2012 and later in 2018. By remaining on the grey list, what will happen? Pakistan, by remaining on the grey list, will not be able to easily get financial aid from international institutions like IMF, World Bank or European Union. So, it will be very difficult for those countries in the grey list to get financial assistance from the financial institutions like World Bank or...
Dear friends, we have covered 40 important topics under regional groupings for this year 2020 prelims. In the next videos, we'll be seeing important topics under India and neighbors, then international organizations, and some international issues. You can also download the PDF format of our PowerPoint by clicking the description given. Thank you.